20 years ago, visiting my friend Kurt, minutes before I had to leave for the train, he said, oh, I gotta show you this puzzle. Just three pieces, and I took it apart, and I couldn't get it back together. And so I snapped a photo of it, and once I got home, I built these pieces, and then figured out how to put it back together. So let's build it again out of this crooked grain piece of ash. And I'm pushing it tight against the fence with push sticks to make sure that the piece is actually going to be square. Something I've done recently is to mark 0.1 millimeter increments on the crank of my planer, which makes it much easier to hit that final thickness in fewer passes. And then cutting those pieces to 32 millimeter lengths to make cubes, it took me a few tries to get that stop set exactly right. With all the cracks and defects in the wood, I didn't even have enough whole cubes to make two puzzles, so I glued some of the cracked ones back together. Checking these for accuracy, these three are a wee bit out of square, size okay. Can't trust these ones entirely either, so I'll only use the good ones for the middle part, and for the end cubes it's less critical. And for getting this alignment just right, I made myself a little guide. It's exactly 16 millimeters here, and the cubes are 32 millimeters. Now I gotta do this one. Oops. Ah, shit. Glue in the wrong spot. Oh, dear. Ah, glue in the wrong spot again. Oh, no, wait. Oh, twice the wrong spot. Arg! It's supposed to be here. Filming takes a bit of focus. So does not screwing up. I only got so much focus. So this, okay, this fits in here, but I don't have enough room to get that between here. So I'll take a little bit off some of these cubes. This face needs to have a little bit taken off. That fits better, but it's still too tight between this face and this face, so I'll take a little bit off of that. Fits now, but too tight. Finally got it loosened up enough so it assembles easily. And only after the fitting do I round the corners, because those round corners can mask a lot of problems. Got the pieces all tweaked. Now, how to put this together? Well, if you look on this, we have these rows of offset cubes like this. And if we look in here, we have a row here and another row kind of going here, and that tells us we need to put a cube somehow right there, and that has to come from this side, because from this side it'd be hard to kind of reach it with anything without putting a cube here, which wouldn't look right. So the only piece that can put a cube like there, well, this one could, but the grain is now in the wrong direction, so we use this piece, and that can put a cube right there. But that gets these two pieces aligned. The cubes, none of the cubes line up side by side. So let's try this way. You can see that looks like the bottom here. So, and none of the cubes line up perfectly, and there's gonna be a little cavity left in the middle. So now we're just gonna get this one in here somehow. And that's the wrong way, so let's flip that around. Gotta put a cube right there. And that's still wrong. So, again, I don't actually have this memorized, but like this, that fits in here, and look at that, that looks correct now. Not until it's all together Does it look like a pyramid?
And what makes this thing so hard to put together is when we assemble something, we try to make things orderly, which means putting cubes side by side, because this thing looks fairly orderly when it's put together, but no cubes on this thing actually line up together, and so our intuition just leads us down the wrong way.
Now the problem with this puzzle is these joints here and here are not very strong, and I've had to glue this one back together twice now because the kids keep dropping it. So I want to make another one, but reinforce those joints with dowels.
And that requires drilling some very precise dowel holes, which is where my milling machine-like contraption comes in.
I got two stops set up on the machine, and I need the hole in the center of a quarter of that, so 8 millimeters from the edge. And I've got an 8 millimeter shaft in here just to kind of find the reference by just touching that up against both stops. And this one here. And that tells me I'm 4 millimeters from the corner. And now let's zero the position. And with the 8 millimeter shaft, I'm already 4 millimeters from the edge here, so I just need to come in 4 millimeters from each side. And I'll make that my new zero.
For more precision, I'm using a very short brad point drill bit, which I made in my last video.
That lines up nice and flush this way and that way. Flush this way and that way and like this. Oh yeah, that's good. But not always. So there's an extra hole in here. This one's a little bit off because the piece tilted a little bit as I drilled, so I have to be very careful. So I'll start with this piece.
And I marked X's where all the holes need to go so I don't have to think about where to put them while I'm drilling.
Let's see if I can assemble those unglued pieces. Okay, I think that's right. And that goes in here. There we go.
And I have to admit, that was take two. It took way too long to figure it out on take one. And now let's glue those bits together. I didn't use clamps on the last one I built because applying clamps can shift the joints around a little bit. But with the dowel pins lining it up on this one, no problem. And not counting setup time, this one actually went together faster than the undoweled one because the time it takes to drill the dowel holes is less than the time it takes to carefully fiddle and line things up without dowels. This time chamfering the edges with a palm plane and a carving knife, no slower than a belt sander and no burning this time. Now every time I've shown this puzzle to a friend, it made them feel stupid, as it did me the first time I saw it, because it's just three pieces, like how hard can it be? And the motivation for this video is I had to glue the other one back together again and I thought, well, I could use this machine to do some precision doweling and that would be a cool thing to show off my machine for. It's kind of a failure as a milling machine, but as a precision drilling machine, it's awesome.